have, other churches have, the apostate, the list of the profile of an apostate, and the people who had crept into the church and causing division. Now, we see problems, but the elders here at Oak Hill, they don't let these type problems come in. I mean, we got problems out there. We got women preachers. That's going on in the world. We got women serving as elders. That's going on in the world. We got churches with instrumental music. You say, well, I was wondering when we were going to get to some of the problems we face. But these are some of the problems we face. People thinking, well, I can do things my way. But because of the strong eldership that we have here at Oak Hill, these things, we refuse to let them come in. I remember going to a church in Atlanta, and we just ended up there that Sunday morning. And this was a church across. I was shocked. They got up to open the service, Michael, and they had the praise teams. But in opening the service, they had the women standing with the men welcoming the congregation. Where do we find that? Where do we have that authority? You might say, well, why is it? And I need to make sure you understand this before we close today. The reason we don't have these people is because the Bible teaches against it. You might say, well, where? You've got to show me where that's found. Well, just open your Bible to 1 Timothy chapter 2. And we'll notice a few verses here. Now let's start with verse 8. I desire therefore that men pray everywhere, lifting up holy hands, without wrath and doubting. In like manner also that the women adorn themselves in modest apparel, with propriety and moderation, not with braided hair of gold, of pearl, costly clothing, but which is proper, professing godliness with a good works. Then he says, let the woman learn in silence with all submission. I do not permit a woman to teach or to have authority over man, but to be in silence. For Adam was formed first, then Eve. And Adam was not deceived, but the woman, being deceived, fell into transgression. Nevertheless, she will be saved in childbearing if they continue in faith, love, and holiness with self-control. So it kind of goes back to this verse 12. I do not permit a woman to teach or have authority over the man. And so we won't ever have, you know, women preachers, women up waiting on the Lord's table. And we have that in some churches. Even in Athens, Georgia, we have that going on. Not preachers, but up presiding over the Lord's table. The Bible doesn't give that authority. And so what I'm saying is, as we contend for the faith, as we close out this epistle, let's make sure we do it in truth. We talked a lot about truth, Michael. You know, in 1 John, we talked a lot about truth. In 1 John, and then 2 John and 3 John, you know, as we walk in the light. So this epistle is all about us contending